So one of the things that we've been really proud of is our guided view technology. And what ended up happening was, so for those who don't know, guided view technology, what it does is it takes the physical page, it doesn't break it up. You know, a lot of our competitors would actually like cut up the page and actually redesign the page. We left the page intact. And what we do is we move you around the page in like little guided view areas, and we mask out the unimportant stuff. And what happened was, you know, it worked very well for phones, but then there was this happy accident. There was a free comic book day issue of Atomic Robo that had this scene where Robo is standing and there's snow behind him. And then the very next panel are robots coming out of the snow. Now, because of the way the technology worked, there was a transition between the snow image and the robot image that it made it appear that the robots were actually coming out of the snow. So we had a couple creators like Alex DeCampi and Riley Brown look at that and say, I want to tell stories that way. And so that's where the Guided View native storytelling method came from, was that this idea that we're going to take this technology that was designed to put comics on your tiny devices, people are actually going to tell stories. And so creators like Mark Waid and Marvel and Tim Gibson and, you know, like I said, Riley Brown, these guys created these comics that are told, first of all, landscape, which I absolutely love. And they're designed to be the full screen, right? So instead of, you know, worrying about how they're going to print this later, like they're looking at it like digital may be the first way and the only way some of these people are going to read this content. So we're going to make content that's specifically designed for this because that's the people we want to reach to. And DC has been very successful with this. They did a comic book tie-in for one of Injustice, their game Injustice, which did amazingly well digitally. So you're able to reach these new audiences through digital, and now people are actually looking at, well, let's tell stories for that. And the Guided View Native storytelling method is part of that. You know, it allows you to think of this, so you have this viewable area. And if you think of it as a canvas, you can build on it, right? You don't necessarily have to have everything appear at once. You know, when you read a comic, you have to have everything there. And when you read it, you know, the only true reveal is the first panel on the left page, because when you have those two pages open, your eye is going down to that bottom panel. So whatever's in that bottom panel is getting, you know, is getting spoiled because, you know, you can see it out of the corner of your eye. Well, with guided view, every reveal is a true reveal, you know, and you're not limited to what's in the current panel. In a print comic, if you want to have a lot of dialogue in a panel this big, you have to figure out where it's going to go. Well, in guided view native storytelling, you can actually have the panels come in, you can build, you can have a conversation, you can have dramatic pause, you can have people, you know, subtle animations, so you could have like someone's head turn or they close their eyes or they sigh. So you can build all of these. It's not truly animation, it's not a motion comic, because you're still interacting with it, you're still controlling it, you're still reading it at your pace. But it allows the creators to take advantage of something that they wouldn't normally have the ability to. And that is by, you know, building elements. So you could have like a really dramatic reveal and have it be a true reveal because no one can see what's coming ahead of it. So I think, you know, as, you know, the technology expands, you're gonna see people starting to design for digital first, and they're gonna worry about print later. And you know, we've had creators like, you know, Joshua Fialkov and Joe Infiari, who, you know, they created this book called The Bunker, and they didn't really want to have to pay for printing costs. They didn't really want to have to distribute it. So they were like, well, let's just do this digitally. And it's been very successful. It was actually, in 2013, it was our most downloaded and our top grossing comic, the first issue. And now they have a TV deal. You know, the print version recently got picked up by Oni. And Joe, for some reason, decided he was going to redraw huge parts of the first issue, which is crazy, but, you know, that's how much they're into it. You know, because he wanted to add some specialness between the digital version and the print version. So, you know, a lot of people are looking at digital as, you know, cheap distribution, the ability to reach a worldwide audience. And then as interest comes, they can then take what they've done and go to places like Kickstarter, or they can solicit a publisher, and then they can get a print version out there that can then go to the stores, and then they can reach, you know, people that way as well.